let's bring our basic 3D text to another level using lights in Fusion. So the first step is go to your effects library, go to effects and drag a new Fusion composition onto your timeline. And with your playhead over that Fusion composition, you can then hop into the Fusion page. And right now, let's build out our basic 3D text. I'm not gonna cover all the steps that I'm doing just because I recently made a dedicated video on how to create a 3D text. If you haven't watched that yet, I highly recommend watching it because it will teach you all the basics that you need in order to create a 3D text. So right now, what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna call this 3D text. Under extrusion, I'm gonna give it some extrusion depth, just a little bit, and then I'm gonna give it some bevel depth and some bevel width. And right now I'm gonna display my 3D text in the viewer number one. This is our basic 3D text, and we're gonna elevate that by using simple lights. So what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna select my merge 3D, hit shift and space bar, and then type in light. And first of all, we need a directional light, and this directional light will act as our key light. For the sake of this tutorial, let's rename that to key. And just some simple lighting knowledge, your key light usually is 45 degrees off to one side. So let's replicate that. And first of all, let's bring this a little bit higher, then bring this back, and then let's move this over to the left side, just like so, or the right side. Right now, we don't see anything. Nothing's happening in our second viewer, which basically is our media out. And that is because we first have to activate lights and shadows. And we do that by going to our renderer 3D in the top right corner where it says inspector. Click on that if that's not already open. And then under lighting, you want to enable lighting and shadows. And immediately you'll see our right side is a little bit brighter than our left side. And if we drag that more to the right side, just like so, that's a good position for a key light to be in. And now let's rotate this something like that. And now let's bring it a little bit down, something like this. This is how you would set up your key light. If you think about lighting, the basic 3-point lighting setup will contain a key light, a fill light, and a backlight. I'm not gonna cover the key light because I feel like that's not necessary for a 3D text, but let's cover the backlight. The easiest way to set up a backlight is just to duplicate the key light. So select the key light, hit Control C and Control V to paste it, then rename it and call this backlight, then connect it into our merge 3D. Select the backlight, display it on viewer number one. And right now we want to bring that one back to its original position, everything. And we want to bring that back because we want to bring that behind the text. And then let's rotate this so that it's facing our text, something like that. Now let's bring this back over here. And if you don't see where the light is hitting your text, you can then select the backlight under your inspector, under the controls tab, you can give it a color. Let's go with something teal. And right now you'll see where exactly the light is hitting your text from behind. And this is actually like right there. And that's pretty good for me. We can actually bring that back a little bit more, rotate it a little bit more. Something like that is looking pretty good to me. And what we could do now, if that's not enough for you, we can add another light, just a point light. So let's go to our merge 3D, hit shift spacebar, and then type in light once again. Select this point light, change the color of the point light to something that stands out. Let's go with red and bring that back. So the red color is where our point light is hitting. And as you can see, this doesn't really fall off. So let's select the point light, go to the inspector in the top right corner under decay type where it says no decay, select linear, and this will just fall off a little bit nicer. Then what we could do is lower the intensity of the light. And as you can see right now, it is hitting our text right here where the T and the E is. And what we could do is now we can animate that, give it some nice yellow color maybe, and then move it completely over to the left side to where it is not visible on our text. Then what we can do is set a keyframe right here maybe under transform on the XX at translation, set a keyframe, then move forward just a couple frames and then move it across your screen just like so. And now if we watch that back, you can see that the light is slowly moving from here, from the three over the complete text to the T and then leaving. And the good thing about the Merge 3D is that you're not limited to just two inputs. As you're in the 2D space where you're limited to a foreground and a background, you're not limited at all. You can have as many inputs as you want in that single Merge 3D. So that means that you can maybe input like 5 to 10 lights if you want. So if that's something that you're going for. So that is just basic guide on how to elevate your 3D text using lights. So that's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If so, please consider leaving a like and a comment. That will mean a ton to me. But anyways, hope you're having a great day. See you in the next one. Bye.